السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته everyone. Brothers and sisters in Islam. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. It's a pleasure for me to be here all the way from Australia and to see these wonderful faces before me. It gives me great confidence. Brothers and sisters, the topic which has been assigned to me is about the companion Uthman ibn Affan رضي الله عنه. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رجال صدقوا ما عاهدوا الله عليه فمنهم من قضى نحبه ومنهم من ينتظر وما بدلوا تبديلا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us about these companions and he calls them men. How are they men? Allah said, they are true men because they fulfilled the promise which they gave to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What they promised, they did. They fulfilled their promise to Allah. Some of them have passed away and some of them still await. There are people who imitate the companions and take them as role models. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put them also in that rank. So we have a chance also to use them as our role models and we can possibly be among those men. Sisters are asking, well, what about me? In Arabic, sometimes you can use the masculine term to refer to both genders. So it means someone who has power over themselves and control over themselves. They have integrity, they have esteem. They're valuable, they're special. وَمَا بَدَّلُوا تَبْدِيلًا Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, during the course of their life, they never changed what they initially promised to do. You know, sometimes we have a surge of iman as time goes on. Our iman goes down, which is normal. But some people, they change, they burn out. For example, some people go into the deen very strongly. They want to be super Muslims. Don't be a super Muslim. Don't be a super Muslim. Take things step by step. Your character is more important than the amount of practice that you do and the way you look. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu was one of those whose character outweighed his actions in the beginning. Then his actions would sometimes outweigh his character. Who are we talking about? We are talking about a man who is the emblem and role model of haya. Haya means modesty and self-respect. Tawadu, which means humility and humbleness. We're talking about a man who is extremely generous. We're talking about a man who used to stay up in the night praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, calling out to Allah. We are talking about a man who was full of sacrifice. He is the man whom the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to his daughter, his first daughter Ruqayya, stay with him. For I don't know anyone more resembling of my character than Uthman. Uthman radiallahu anhu has the closest character to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So let's look at his character first of all. Honestly, I love talking about Uthman radiallahu anhu. And each companion has their own character, their own passion, and they have their own personality. So you'll never find one companion who fits all. And every single one of you here will find themselves similar to one or two of the companions. And none of us are all the same. You've got the tough ones, you've got the soft ones, you've got the firm ones, you've got the ones who are a bit lenient, you've got the shy ones, you've got the ones who are very confident and out there, extroverts, introverts, all of them have their positivity. And that, I'm saying that so none of you can ever look down upon yourself because you have a particular personality. Be proud of it. That's the personality Allah has given you and you need to know how to use it to benefit yourself and benefit the community. And do what's best that makes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pleased for you to enter paradise and live a good life with happiness. Be proud about who you are, so long as it's right. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Ali radiallahu anhu said, you are asking me about Uthman, who is nicknamed by the angels as Dhun-Nurayn, the man of the two lights. You know who the two lights are? They are his two wives. Not at the same time. They are the two prophet, the two daughters of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He married first Ruqayya radiyallahu anha, the daughter of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then she died. Then he married Umm Kulthum, the daughter of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then she died, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to him, "Wallahi ya Uthman, if I had a third daughter, I will give her to you." Brothers and sisters in Islam, let's see why. Uthman, before Islam, was loved by Quraysh. The non-Muslims loved him. Do you know why they loved him? Because he was wealthy, and wait for it, he was humble. It's very rare to find someone who is very wealthy and yet as humble can be. If you are like that, then Allah has blessed you with this wealth, and you will win both this world and the next. Humbleness, tawadu. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man tawadu'a lillahi rafa'a." Whoever humbles themselves before Allah, Allah will lift them. He will lift your esteem, and people will love you. And I'm not talking about fake love. I'm not talking about people who just look good on fake book. Did I say fake book? I said fake book, didn't I? Facebook should be called fake book. But I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about genuine people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made people to love them. Even non-Muslims would love you because of your character. Uthman radiallahu anhu was born 6 years after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was medium built, wide shoulders, soft looking. When you looked at him, he looked soft. And you enjoyed his company. He was approachable. He never committed zina. You know what zina is? Fornication, adultery, you know, sleeping around in the haram way. He never committed zina even before Islam. He never murdered anyone. He never committed shirk. He never worshipped an idol even before Islam. He didn't drink alcohol. In fact, he was against it. He was against alcohol. One day, he desired to marry the Prophet's daughter, Ruqayya. Let's take you through the sequence. And the Prophet's uncle, Abu Lahab. You all know Abu Lahab, right? You know, you met him? No, okay, say that. Abu Lahab, the man of fire, in the other way, he was a man of hellfire. He's the one that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down the verse, Tabbat yada Abi Lahabin wa tab. Now, I want the young people, I just want to take this time for the young people to listen to this. Look, listen to how it sounds. Tabbat yada Abi Lahabin wa tab. It's got a bounce to it, isn't it? It's like rap, isn't it? Is it? I just said something terrible, didn't I? Quran is not like rap, but it does have a bounce to it. And it's a deliberate bounce. Why? Because look what happened. When this guy Abu Lahab, he started cursing his own nephew, he started talking bad about him after Islam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has brought down this verse and it sounded like a bounce. You know why? Because he wanted the children to start singing it like as if it's a song. But it was really Quran. Every child in Mecca absorbed it and it had a catchy sound to it. So every one of them started to, they used to run and play while reading Tabbat yada Abi Lahabin wa tab. And Abu Lahab would come past and he would get angry and say, "Stop it, shut up." And the children would laugh. You know how the children would run off and they go, "Ha, Tabbat yada Abi Lahabin wa tab." Mate, if you want to humiliate yourself, just pick on a kid. Brothers and sisters, this man Abu Lahab used to love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So his son Utbah, he married the Prophet's daughter Ruqayya before Islam. And Uthman radiallahu anhu, he had a secret passion for her. He loved her, right? It's like what you say when someone has a crush on someone, but this was a real crush because Uthman radiallahu anhu, he loved her. And there's nothing wrong with somebody having certain feelings towards someone after they've seen their character and, you know, what family they come from. That's fine, but just keep it to yourself and don't do anything haram. I'm a teacher and some students, they always ask me, "I like this guy, I like this girl, what can I do?" I say, keep liking him until the day comes when you're able to get married to him. And go and ask for them from their parents. You know, don't do hanky-panky stuff. Go around the corner and start meeting in secret and stuff like that. No. Do it the right way. I promise you she'll respect you. And you'll respect her. But there's nothing wrong with liking someone. Just keep it to yourself, and maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will get you married to them, maybe not. So Uthman radiallahu anhu had a secret love for her, and she married Utbah. He was so sad and he was so hurt. So one day, Sa'da, his auntie, came to him and said, I've got good news for you. There is a man who says he's a prophet, and he's brought a Quran. And this is the Quran. She recited some verses to him, and she had embraced Islam. He said, what, a man who says he's a prophet from Quraysh? She says, yeah, come and meet him. So Uthman radiallahu anhu went on his way. He met Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. And Abu Bakr was one of his closest friends. He said to him, I've heard of a man saying he's a prophet. And Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu said, yes, he is as-sadiq al-ameen, the truthful one, the most trustworthy. He said, none other but him. He said, yes. He said, this is what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying. And Uthman said, this sounds amazing. He went and met the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Within about 10 to 15 minutes, he embraced Islam. He was among the first five to embrace Islam. Uthman radiallahu anhu believed the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he knew what character meant, because he had the similar character. And so Abu Lahab went against the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to the point where he got his son Utbah and he said, hey, listen, come here. Son, divorce the Prophet's daughter. Divorce Muhammad's daughter sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, why? He said, because we want to hurt him. Divorce her. And he divorced her. So Uthman radiallahu anhu jumped in the air and said, this is my opportunity. He went to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, I want to marry her, ya Rasulullah. And the Prophet, peace be upon him, did not hesitate. He married Ruqayya, and time passed. Now I want to tell you something. Both of them were good looking. Ruqayya was really good looking, radiallahu anha, and Uthman was actually quite good looking. He was very handsome. And on the night of their wedding, people used to say, they made poetry about him, saying, the two good looking couple. When Ruqayya radiallahu anha died, it was after the Battle of Badr, and it broke Medina's heart, you know. And he didn't join the Battle of Badr because the Prophet ﷺ told him, you have to look after Ruqayya, go and nurse her. When your wife is sick, nurse her, look after her. And he looked after her. He didn't even go to the Battle of Badr. It was more important to look after his wife's well-being and sickness. When the Prophet, peace be upon him, returned, Ruqayya died after a few days. And Uthman and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was so saddened. He was really saddened for her loss. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave him Umm Kulthum. He married Umm Kulthum. And time passed. Umm Kulthum also died. And Uthman radiallahu anhu was left without a wife again. So he married someone else, and he would never forget his two beautiful wives. He was called the Nurain, the man of the two lights. There came a time when the Muslims had to fight an Eastern Roman Empire from a Sham. It was called the Battle of Tabuk. And it was called the Expedition of Usra. The army of the Muslims were in terrible state. They needed wealth, they needed horses, they needed cavalry, they needed armor, everything. They needed weapons. So there was a call to help. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu came and he gave all of his wealth, which was only a little bit. He was carrying it on top of his shoulders. Umar radiallahu anhu comes along and he said, yes, Abu Bakr has only got a little bit this time. This time I'm going to beat him. So he brought half of his wealth, and the bag was a little bit bigger than Abu Bakr's bag. He said, today I'm going to beat him. When he reached the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he found that Abu Bakr hadn't left anything for his family. And Umar radiallahu anhu took half of his wealth. So that's when Umar radiallahu anhu said, I wish I was a hair on the chest of Abu Bakr at least. But Uthman radiallahu anhu came along and he donated 100 plus 100 plus 100 plus 100 up to 900 camel loads of stuff. Then he added on top of that 90 horses, then 700 gold coins, followed by 10,000 silver coins. Man, that is a lot of money. We're talking about hundreds of thousands of dollars, maybe $1 million, pounds. We say dollars in Australia. And the Prophet ﷺ said, مَا ضَرَّ عُثْمَان مَا فَعَلَ بَعْدَ الْيَوْمِ. Nothing that Uthman does after today is going to harm him. And he said it three times. Uthman radiallahu anhu also bought something called the Well of Roma. Not Roma as in Rome. There was a Jewish man named something Roma. And he sold this water. Muslims were in need of water in Medina. They had no other water. And there was this big well that was there, and no one could buy it. So Uthman radiallahu anhu bought it for 38,000 dirhams. Again, it's something like saying 100,000 pounds or something like that. He bought it for the Muslims. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because he said, "Man hafara bi'ra Ruma falahu al-jannah." Whoever buys the well of Ruma, then he will have paradise. And that was for Uthman radiallahu anhu. You know what, brothers and sisters? Till today, the well of Ruma is still existing in Saudi Arabia. And there is a bank that's a trustee just for Uthman radiallahu anhu. Half of it goes to the poor every year, and half of it goes into the investment or the assets of, under the name of Uthman radiallahu anhu. And they use it to develop and to look after orphans and other people like that. Till today, this is a sadaqah jariyah, an ongoing charity from Uthman radiallahu anhu, till today.